Hey everybody, OmniGriffin here, and welcome back to the Solus project. As these, there we go. As the textures load in. So last time we left, we were dead to lava. And there's still something I'm missing about this. Overheating. We are totally overheating right now. Let's not overheat, shall we? Now we're too cold. Let's just put everything away. That's reasonable. Alright, so. We discovered that if we push this button, we would open one of those gates. But there are clearly other gates that need to be pressed. Oh! There's a ladder here. Crap. Okay, so there's a lot more to this than I thought. Okay, so there is water in here, as well as food. But this doesn't actually help me. Does it? I'm very overheated right now. Yeah, there doesn't appear to be anything over here that's useful. But maybe there are other staircases that do have something useful in them. Oh, well, right. Oh, I wonder if the button opens that door. No. Crap. So that doesn't do anything. So it's over here. Maybe something that opens that door. I'm trying to keep an eye out for booby traps here. Okay, more food and stuff. I do realize that there's something over there, but I want to check this first. Okay. Okay. So that's a second button. I bet you this opens the other door. Do these do anything? Secret up there. That was a weird sound. Alright. So we know where a second button is. Two might be enough. But I want to check out over here first. Ooh, we're above. Okay. Oh, hi. Okay, that's part. Oh, look. Okay, so there's at least three buttons. Ooh. Caretaker's Tryst. Oh, and that is this. Okay, so three buttons. I have to figure out a way to press all of them fast enough since they all seem to have that timer. First off, are there any keys nearby? No. How about swords? No. Wait, can we do that? We can! Crap. That means there's tower parts nearby. But they would be by wreckages, so we would have seen them. There aren't any wreckages that we missed, are there? We need all the tower parts we can get. I think we actually need every single one that Oh! Meteor! Wait, did we already find this? I totally don't remember. I mean, the buff only lasts so long, so... I didn't even see what it was to. Heatstroke and dehydration. That's pretty normal. This is our one wreckage. I mean, there's a beacon, but I didn't try picking everything up. There's also still a backpack around. Wait. Oh, that is just a tower part. Okay. Never mind. That's right, we already got the guinea pig. There's a backpack here somewhere, too. I'm very confused as to what the hell is going on here. So I'm just going to ignore it, because that's a bug. Alright, so that means there's a... Oh, crap. That's the only wreckage that we saw, though, right? I'm trying to remember if we saw one over here. That one had a little, like, beacon thing to it. And I haven't seen anything else like that, so maybe it's past the door, the other one? It'd be really odd for them to be so close together. Maybe? I don't know if that's true. I've definitely explored the other coast thoroughly. So unless there's wreckage somewhere around here... I'm gonna go with we keep in mind that there's another one nearby. And look for more wreckage. Holy crap. Yeah, I don't see any other wreckage, so... Let's go ahead and save real fast, and then let's try and pull this off. So... We need to teleport across there, but if we end up right there, oh, I can't make that. So we have to end here. Okay, that's doable. Weird how that didn't work. Okay, so we step on that one first. You have to come all the way back down here. Alright, I think this is how we do this. We gotta hit three buttons in rapid succession. Teleportation seems like a must here. Oh, okay. I thought we were gonna have to do something else. Thought we were gonna have to try and get through there. Forward vector achieved. We investigated the wall. Oh yeah. Oh my god. Milestone 2 of 3. Spot of forbidden steps. I wonder if there's anything under there. Really? That's fall damage. How's temperature? Okay, temperature's not too bad. Oh wow, those are cold. That makes some sense. Let's go eat. We've got gruel in here. We might as well use it. That's weird. I bounced off that. Weird. I'm glad that ended up being simpler than I thought. I ate at least three. I hope there's water out here somewhere. I'm just gonna drink from water bottles. The longer we're in here in this extreme heat, the more likely we are to just dehydrate really fast. It's not worth sticking around. So warm out. Holy shit. Step on that. Oh god, oh god, oh god. Fail. So cold. Oh. Well, let's put this away. Doing basic symbol matching. Maybe that doesn't do what I think it does. But those match the symbols on the ground. Do they? Right. That's the square. And that's the doohickey. Yeah, we're matching. So, I don't know how useful that is, or what it actually does. There's that wonderful floating pyramid over there. Dehydration imminent. Yeah, I know. Let's explore. By explore, I mean let's run up the steps to the place where we're obviously supposed to go, but it's probably locked. Excuse me. I'm waiting for, like, just some death trap that I'm not used to. That isn't just climbing stairs in ridiculous heat. Fine, fine. Don't know if that really counts as exploring. Enter the gate. Well, we gotta do something to open the gate first. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, totally almost fell to my death. Well, bonsai. Let's go exploring. We've got a tower piece to find, and a backpack to find. It's a little cold. Look, eyes. Oh, come on. I barely fell. Operator, health improved. Make me do this. Oh, this is something. Operator, health. Operator, health improved. Who are you? Relic of Aqua. Operator, health improved. Resistance to dehydration. Our max health's like, what, 725 now? Check. There's something shiny over here. Oh, I bet you I need to line up all of these. Because there's another one. Just a giant fish skeleton. Good thing we haven't found any of the giant fish. Locate materials for satellite uplink. No shit. I wonder if it's saying that because it knows there's something nearby. See, the skeleton right in the water there makes me worry. But, like, we haven't seen any of them yet. Is that a giant fish skull? Alright, we had one of those things. Where was it? I didn't bypass it, did I? Yes, I did. Shortage of sleep, you're telling me. Actually, where are we at? 1.2 hours, we're fine. Make me do this the long way. Okay, so that did something, even though the other one didn't. Oh, I bet you that one just has to be lined. Oh. Got one of those floating spheres. Being all ominous and shit over there. Ow. Wow, that did 100 damage. I'm not going to worry about eating that back up out of the alien skull, because we're going to be sleeping soon. And by soon, I mean very soon. Hello, eyeball. Bunch more rocks on the beach. Oh, that's something. I don't like that. I think it's gonna shoot at me. Okay, this looks promising for finding the tower part and or the backpack. Looks like a bunch of storage crates. Picture of cats. Operator quit. Unfortunately, I don't have other good light sources right now. There's nothing in here. Alright, well, good thing we've got the heat orb. Bad thing we've got the heat orb. Being cold is the correct answer here, it looks like. We're just gonna avoid that gun. Because that's all it looks like is a gun. Here we go. Doggo. MREs.
Inventory full.
Three MREs. Okay. We can come back if we find the backpack, I guess. That's just a plant in the ground. Oh, come on, we can get rid of that. Alright, the correct answer is just set this up to be correct. And then looks like it's got two prongs going up on opposite sides. So if it's not that one, it's the second one. Simple.
Operator tired. Sleep advised.
Yeah, I'm at that point. Alright, we'll sleep real fast. We've still got time for this episode. It it's gonna end up hot, so we just sleep here. I think we're gonna wake up due to overheating. Have to blow my nose real fast. Oh, it's raining. That's not what I expected. But
sleep disturbed by rain.
I'm okay with that. I don't know why we're getting the ominous music.
Climate anomaly detected.
Oh, because that. We are not protected here. We are not safe here. Oh, holy shit. Well, there's only so much you can do. And I realize we're wet, but we're warm enough. Yeah, there's not much I can do if this comes straight at me. Which it is. Alright, well, now that that's gone.
Operator, wet.
Oh shit. Oh, look. Lighter, water bottle.
Operator, wet.
Ooh, scuba mask. Might need another light source. Ooh, page. Post-Earth history. Human life is like electricity. We desire the path of least resistance, but it is never the best way forward. The day of tears, when the three colony ships heaved themselves free of Earth's atmosphere, was the path of pain, necessary agony. Yeah, nobody wants to leave their home. Doggo. Oh, backpack. Inventory plus three. Number 12, yeah. Within 3 years, the rogue star reached the solar system. Transmissions from the colony silos buried in the earth ceased. The beautiful chaos of our sun's death and our home's obliteration was watched by the 200,000 orphaned survivors of the human race. So, yep. Rogue sun obliterates your solar system. It's usually pretty bad day for a lot of people. Alright, so we found the backpack, so we can grab some MREs. Don't need the lighter. We already have one. That's what I mean by that. Should I go back and grab the other MREs? Oop, another piece of paper. Yep, 10. Those who could afford an abundance of resources, now at a premium, built private ships to escape the atmosphere on their own. In coming decades, they would come to be known as the Parasites, fringe survivors who flanked the Prolus ships unofficially.
Operator, wet.
I mean, yeah. Okay, that's not actually new, it's just an edible plant. There's gotta be another wreck here that has the tower part. I suppose the other tower part could be the power source that we've been looking for. That actually, that makes a lot of sense. Since that's kind of why we're here. Although it could be in another part of the map still. Like, oh.
Operator, wet.
Is that a ship or is that just a rock formation? Can't tell from here. We're doing good on temperature. Ooh, save spot. I'll take that. I don't believe you. Yep, I don't believe you. And let's fill our empty water bottles. Okay, we are a little cold now, it looks like. The feeding place. Herein thou shalt walk the path of giving. Herein thou shalt heal the wounds of the sea. If the path stands complete, the sunken one shall present itself. That sounds dangerous. Like we're gonna get eaten by a ginormous fish. Yeah, I don't know how much that, you know what? Screw it. Bonsai. Aww. I don't know what I was hoping for, but... Oh, that looked like an entrance. Should probably not drown. Let's not do that. Alright, let's go set up our, whatchamacallit, our little tower over there. No giant fish come to eat me. I mean, it'd be a good way to turn the water into a boundary if that fish actually existed. But they're just playing on the fact that I know that they're a giant fish because A, we've seen skeletons, and B, we've seen one with its eyes moving to prevent you from maybe jumping in as often as I have.
Warning. Operator, cold and wet. Temperature dropping.
I sincerely doubt that. Considering that I am about to, like, die of cold, or die of heat. Okay. Oh, wait. Dang it, it was on the right one. Here we go, more wreckage. So there could be a tower part here. We are also running low on sleep again. Oh, looks like there could be something in here. It is a little warm. Oh, I see a beacon right there. Getting some sad music. Oh man, that's a lot of wreckage, actually. Cat. Dog. Beacon, don't need. The three evacuation ships, the Proless colonies, came under extreme criticism. Our habits of nepotism and elitism bubbled to the surface. The selection process was brutal. Spaces on the ships, Opie's, Imito, Dinah, were filled within hours. Yeah, nepotism will do that. Hey, like a pillow! We don't need a pillow. We already have one. Another dog. Water bottle. I need to put this away. We're getting too cold. We had neither means nor time to evacuate all of the planet's 12 billion strong population, so two plans were made. One to burrow deep into Earth for safety, one to flee into space. 99.9% of humanity were assigned to the former, near suicidal option. To stay, which we already learned didn't work. We still haven't found page number 9. Oh. Difficult decisions were made. The leaders of the near ubiquitous United Nations gathered and organized a human seed, the Proless Project. It was ambitious, blending the best of our technology, resources, and means with the potent drop of desperation.
Inventory full. Operator tired. Sleep advised.
I will sleep when I... Oh, that's gonna hurt. Oh, didn't. I'm gonna sleep and we're gonna end the episode. Maybe. Oh, that is oil for torches.
Inventory full.
Champagne. And videotapes. Yeah, not sure where page 9 is. Don't know if we'll ever actually find it. I'm curious to read them all, but I'm not gonna go too crazy to do it. It's possible it was at the other location also. Or it's over here, where there's a lot more.
Operator,
wet. Yup, I am. Thing about rain.
Operator tired. Sleep advised.
Oh yeah, we're really hurting on sleep. I don't want to end the episode just yet though. But I guess we have to. We gotta sleep, and we're on a good path.
Reminder, your survival is of paramount importance.
We've got some shelter. So we're gonna take advantage of this shelter here. And we're gonna sleep.
Operator.
For a nice, solid 8 hours. We're gonna ignore the fact that that doesn't really matter. Alright, we're actually gonna hit it to 9 hours. We're sheltered. Yeah, I'm all the way in the corner of this, and hopefully the weather's not reaching me. So yeah, I guess that's going to be it for this episode. Presuming that we don't get awoken mid-sleep. But it looks like we're good. We've made some good progress. We found out a lot about the backstory of all this. And we are now ready to try and make our way into that gate. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I will see you next time as we continue to try and break our way into that wonderful little city castle thing that hopefully has a power source for our emitter. And yeah, I'm very excited to see where this goes. I definitely like the story that's going on here. And I hope that we get to find out how all of it ends. But we will have to wait until a future episode, and until then, keep your gears turning.